upon the 21st day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Such a nice guy.
You don't mean nice guys when you live on Skid Row, Mr. Schnick.
I got these plants repotted for you, Mr.
Seymour, look what you did to the inventory.
Kill it, Seymour, Mr. Schnick.
Hi, Audrey. You look radiant today. Is that new eye makeup?
I'll clean it up before any of the customers get here.
Well, that ought to give you plenty of time. God, what an existence I got. Misfit employees, bums on the sidewalk, business is lousy. My life is a living hell. Urgent! Away from my storefront. It ain't bad enough I got winos permanently decorating it that I gotta have three worthless ragamuffins like you to complete my picture.
We ain't bothering nobody, are we, Crystal? No, we're not, Renette.
You ought to be in school.
Yeah, we on a split shift.
Right, we went to school until the fifth grade, then we split.
Well, how do you intend to better yourselves?
Better yourselves? Mr. When you from Skid Row, ain't no such thing.
But I'm You that what the firm may need is to move in a new direction?
What Sean was trying to say, Mr. Mushnick, is, well, we've both been thinking about it, and we both think that maybe, Sean, why don't you run out back and bring out some of those plants you've been working on? You see, Mr. Mushnick, some of those plants he's been working on, they're really quite interesting. And we were both thinking that maybe some of those strange and interesting plants, prominently displayed and advertised, would attract business.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
There! Now, isn't that bizarre?
At least! What kind of a weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of fly trap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. Gave it my own name, though. I call it an Audrey too.
After me.
I hope you don't mind. See, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, then maybe...
Maybe what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't just suddenly appear. Excuse me, I couldn't help noticing that strange and interesting plant. What is it?
It's an Audrey too.
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Well, where did you get it?
You remember that total eclipse of the sun? Just a couple weeks ago.
Well...
Very dark. Then I heard a strange humming sound, like something from another world. But when the light came back on, this little plant was just sitting there. Just stuck in, you know, among the zinnias. I could have sworn it hadn't been there before, but the old Chinese man sold it to me anyway for $1.95.
Well, that's a fascinating story, and a strange and interesting plant. Oh, while I'm here, I may as well take $50 worth of roses.
$50?
$50?
$50?
Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Can you break 100?
100? No. I'm afraid we closed the register for today.
Well then, I'll just have to take twice as many, won't I?
Twice as many?
Twice as many?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Right away, sir. Audrey, my darling, kindly fetch this wonderful gentleman $100 worth of our finest red American Beauty roses.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. That is one strange and interesting plant.
Well, don't just stand there. Put that, what did you call it?
An Audrey 2.
Well, put the Audrey 2 over here on the counter where the customers can see it. My God, I'd never have believed it. My children, I'm taking us to dinner. I'm telling you, Audrey, you don't need a date with him. You need major medical. He ain't a good, clean kind of boy.
He's a professional, Mr. Mushnick.
What kind of a professional? Drives a motorcycle and wears a black leather jacket.
He's a rebel. And besides, he makes good money. Enjoy dinner. Good night, Mr. Mushnick. Good night, Seymour.
Good night, Audrey.
Poor girl.
Are we still going to dinner?
You, Seymour, are not going anywhere with this plant looking like this. How come it looks so sickly?
I told you it's been giving me trouble. The Audrey, too, is not a healthy girl.
Strictly between you and me, Seymour, neither is the Audrey 1.
If only I knew what breed it was, what genus, but it's nowhere in the books.
Well, my advice to you, Seymour, is you better figure it out fast. Look what this exotic little beauty did for my business.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix. Good night, Seymour.
Oh, Timmy, I don't know what else to do for you. Mr. Mushnick and Audrey, they just met you, but I've been going through this for you for weeks. Throwing will, spur and bluff. Are you sickly little plant? Or are you just plain stubborn? What is it that you want? What is it you need? You're so light. Thank you.
drops wouldn't hurt. So long as you don't make a habit out of it or anything.
I've given you plenty. I've given you rain. Looks like you're not happy. Unless I open a vein. I'll give you a few drops. If that'll appease. Now please, oh please, grow for me?
It seems incredible that young Botanical, do you mind if I call you a genius?
No.
The genius who has developed a new breed of plant life hitherto unknown on this planet, the Argentu. Oh, just wanted to ask a question, Mr. Frogo. Do you believe in anything special?
No. It's a secret formula, but it's not hard to come by.
I see. Well, thanks for dropping by, and
I'd like to remind our listeners that the RG2 is on display exclusively at Mission Skid Row Florist.
Well, thank you.
Open six days
of station WSKID.
Near grass, near grass. Oh well, it's still great advertising. Can't believe it. It couldn't be happening. Catch me, girls. It couldn't be happening. All of this sun's that's coming out of the blue. Put a sign up right in the front window. An advertisement right in the front window. Stop in and see the amazing new plant of Ritu. And the really remarkable things the people they do. See more that dwarf all the club smiley. Did something right. Audrey Coop drives them nuts. What a blessing. This wonderful plant should exist. It should rake in love bugs on hand over fist. The address of the shop. How many times have I told you?
I'm sorry, son. I was nervous. Where's Audrey? She said she'd be here.
Forget about Audrey. I got three radio interviews lined up. Morris, Howard wants the picture. Get in, girls! Come on, Simon. Let's get this to the paper.
You better, Mother. She'd be so proud.
You're an overnight sensation, Simon.
Woo! Who'd have believed it?
sure did.
Oh, Timo's first radio broadcast. I wanted to be on time. I wanted to cheer him on, but...
Let me guess. You got tied up.
No. Just handcuffed. A little.
Girl, I don't know who this mess is you hanging out with, but he is hazardous to your health.
Well, that's for sure. But I can't leave him.
Why not?
Because if he does this to me when he likes me, imagine what he'd do if he got mad.
So dump the chunk. Find somebody else that can really protect you.
And we got one all picked out.
A little botanical genius.
And she's not talking about
Alan. See?
Bingo!
Oh, I can never be seen this one. I can't pass.
Baby, you gotta pass? We all gotta pass.
Disposal is a sin.
Meatloaf and water, floors to sweep, toilets to clean, and every other Sunday off.
You know, I think you ought to raise your victims. Now we're getting successful. Maybe you could start with some new clothes. No offense, but a big, important botanist has to look the part.
Oh, I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste like you. You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen with me in a public place? Like a department store?
Sure.
Tonight?
Oh, I can't tonight. I got a date. Maybe some other time?
Sure, I'll pencil you in.
Guess you got a lot of dates now, huh?
Not dates, exactly. But a lot of garden clubs have been calling me, asking me to give lectures.
Gee!
Imagine me giving lectures. I barely even finished grade school.
Oh, that doesn't matter. You got a lot of experience.
Some experience. I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Oh, me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Oh! It's not that great. And besides, it's really dangerous.
It is?
Uh-huh. Oh, is that the time? I gotta go fix my things. My dad will be here any minute.
I better go finish some stuff out back.
Excuse me, ladies. Which way to 36 Skid Row?
I'm afraid that kind of information is going to cost you a dollar.
Hey, no prob. Here you go.
So right over there. But if you're like everybody else, coming down to see the Audrey 2, you better come back tomorrow, man.
The shop is closed today. Took his dollar.
I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date? You ain't by any chance talking about a girl with a black eye and several other medical problems?
As a matter of fact...
That's him! That's the one! Get out!
Ladies! Please! Truce! I'm friendly. You want some nitrous oxide?
Get lost, Vitalis brains. The last thing Audrey needs is more of your kind.
My kind's a very nice kind, ladies. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it an occupational hazard.
Sarah?
You see, girls, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. Woohoo! Oh, this stuff is great.
Oh, allow me to explain.
Bad little kid. My mama noticed funny things I did. Flashing puppies with a BB gun. I'd pull some guppies and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat and bash in his head. That's when my mama said,
what did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural dead. You'll be a dead. Temperaments wrong for the priesthood and teaching would seem to still less. Some be a dancer, you'll be a success. I'm a dentist and a success. Say ah.
Tell me, but you have to leave now. We...
It's okay, Seymour. This is my boyfriend. Seymour? I'm Scavello. DDS.
So anyway, as I was saying, you said you raised this thing, right?
Right.
Well, I sure as hell would keep it under a barrel down in a skid row dump like this. Hell, this avocado could be a ticket to the stars. You could take this plant to any florist shop in town and name your price. Hell, somebody make you a goddamn partner to get their hands on something like this.
I don't care. I'm happy here.
Oh, Seymour's very loyal.
Somebody talking to you?
Oh, no. So sorry.
Sorry what?
Sorry, doctor.
That's better. So anyway, this thing's a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this car and take the plan with you. What? Mushnik Skid Row florists? It's like a joke. You hear me laughing?
I hear you.
He hears them.
Should we be leaving now? I'm sorry.
Sorry what?
I'm sorry, doctor. I'm sorry, doctor.
You gotta train me, stud. Well, my bike's outside, and I'm double parked. But you think about what I said, Scout. I mean it. You think about it.
I'll think about it.
Think about it.
All right, Audrey!
You got the handcuffs?
Bring
them back. Then let's go.
He'll think about it. He'll think about it.
I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnik. And you should hear the way he talks about Audrey.
God in him, Mono. The kid just said he'd mull it over.
No wonder she looks so under the weather. It's enough to make him sick.
If he left me. If Seymour left me. Why then I'll be right back where I started. Which was broke and starved.
Mushnik's taking a junior.
someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? Who cares if I've had a little few dizzy patches, a little lightheadedness? It's been worth it, old pal. Hey, Tui, I'm a little hungry. I'm gonna run down the corner and pick up a bite to eat. I'll see you in the... Oh, boy. Here we go again. Look, I haven't got much more left. Just give me a few more days for this to heal, and we'll start on the right hand, and then...
Feed me.
I beg your pardon?
Feed me.
Hey, Tui, you talked. You opened your trap, your thing, and you said...
Feed me, Krillborn, feed me now.
I can't.
But I'm starving.
Oh, boy, maybe I can squeeze a little more out of this one.
I need some food.
I'm trying, but you can't get food from a...
More.
I don't got any more. What do you want me to do? Slit my wrists? Look, I'll run down the corner and pick you up some nice chopped sirloin.
Must be blood.
Tui, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't know if I want to hear this.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
Am I supposed to get it?
Feed me some more. Feed me all night long. That's right, boy. You can do it. Feed me some more. Feed me all night long. Cause if you feed me Seymour, I can grow up big and strong.
You eat blood orgy too? That's disgusting. Let's face it, how am I supposed to get it? Kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all a coincidence, baby? The sudden success around here? Your adoption papers?
Look, you're a plant, an inanimate object.
Does this look inanimate to you, punk? If I can talk and I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want?
Like what?
Like deliver pal. Like see you get everything your secret, greasy heart desires. Would you like to catch in that car? Or get shot on jackpot? How about a date with Ed Lamar? You're gonna get it if you want it, baby. How'd you like to be a big wheel? Dining out for every meal. I'm the plan to make it all real. You're gonna get it. I'm your winning slave. Take a chance, be man. You know the kind of eating, kind of red hot treat, the kind of thinking, licking, sweet on break. Wow! Come on, Seymour, don't be a punk. Trust me and your life is truly Bible kingdom. Show a little initiative, work with those guts and you'll get it.
I don't know.
Come on, kid, what will it be? Money? Girl? What particular girl? How about that Audrey? Think it over. There must be someone you can 86 real wide by and get me some lunch. How's about a room with the wrist wrapped in velvet covered in glitz? A little looky gonna keep your thing, you'll get it.
Wait a minute, it's not a very nice thing to say.
But it's true, isn't it?
No, I don't know anybody who deserves to get chopped up and fed to a hungry plant.
Sure you do.
Stupid woman! Klaus, what a friggin' scatter brain! Get the hell in there and pick up the goddamn sweater! Dizzy cow!
How'd you like that stupid dame? Get the friggin' sweater!
Come on, move it, you little slut!
Now, do it now. Just a micro pressure right here on the river and on the ground. mask off, Ed. Hey, Seymour, guess what?
What?
The mask gets stuck. I can't get it off. Give me a hand.
Well?
He says, well.
Seymour, I don't think you quite understand what's going on here.
Don't be foolish.
Flores, how can I help you?
Okay, then, thank you ever so much. Goodbye.
Can you hold, please?
Oh, what a day, what a day. Seymour, can you walk up for me? I'm all in.
1 minute, Audrey. I just need to show you something.
Oh, can I wait till tomorrow?
It's not going to take long. I've been shopping for a new wardrobe like you told me to. And... ta-da!
Oh, Seymour!
What do you think?
I...
I'll take it off. I'll take it back. I'll burn it. Just please, Audrey. Oh, look what I did. I only bought it to impress you. That's all I ever meant to do. It's Aaron, isn't it? You've been down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. I miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I ain't never been so relieved as the day they told me he vanished. It's like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I saved on Epsom salts and its vanishes.
Then what's the matter, then?
I feel guilty, I guess. I mean... met with a play of some kind or an accident, and you know, it's probably my fault. Secretly, I wish.
Audrey, don't spend one more minute worrying about that creep. There's a lot of guys out there who would do anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
Oh, I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
You don't know the half of it. I live a terrible life. I deserve a creep. I worked there on my days off when we weren't making much money. He put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones like these. No. Nasty and terrible as I know.
Audrey, it's all behind you now.
You don't have anything to be ashamed of.
You're a very nice person. Not always who you were. Underneath the bruises and the hiccups. You know what I saw? Girl, I respect.
Lift up your head, push up your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. Though things were bad, but now they're
thank you.
seems the plot is thickening among my employees.
Please, Mr. Daddy.
Don't you, Mr. Daddy, me, Crowborn. Audrey, I wonder if you'd excuse Seymour and I for a while. Perhaps you'd like to go and visit your dentist friend.
It's not very funny, Dad. You know he disappeared.
Oh, that's right. He did, didn't he? Forgive me, boy, it's your kids.
Seymour, what's he talking about? What's he doing?
You run along like you said, Audrey. I'll catch up with you later. I'll call you if that's okay.
There are rat dots all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, huh?
I had a pretty strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called to the police.
The police?
That's right. It seems they made a routine investigation into the disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, it seems they found a Michigan Skid Row florist back in his office.
What's that? What do you mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. And then I began to think about things I noticed around here. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch, and it stained.
Hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it?
Especially when they only empty our garbage once a month. What's that got to do with... Where are you going? Do you want something promoted in a hurry, Seymour? It's best not to discuss it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist.
He's got your number now. He knows just what you've done. You got no place to hide.
Rebella's office showed it to me and asked if I could identify it.
And did you?
No. They don't suspect you at all, Seymour. But they don't know about the dots. The uniform. The gopher.
I didn't do it!
Then come with me to the police and tell them.
He's got his facts all straight.
So my conscience will rest easy.
You know he's on your trail.
And is it true the shop is decorating the senior prom?
Yes, yes, it's all true. Now, please, I...
tawdry and impoverished as before,
she might not want me. She might not like me. Without the plan, she might not love me anymore. Where do I stand? Right on the line. That'll do fine. This copy's mine. Couldn't go wrong.
I was just a nothing again, a nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
What settled? A gun!
And bullets, and rat poison, and a machete. Tomorrow morning, right after Life magazine takes our pictures, you know who bites the dust.
Seymour!
Right? They'll snap the photo, we'll be famous, I'll take that TV job, and we'll go and live a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more night feedings. No more squalling for blood.
What night feedings? What blood? I don't get it, Seymour! You're scaring me!
There's nothing to be scared of. We'll go away from here. I'll take you to that little development you always dreamed about. And once we're there, we'll live happily ever after. I promise. Nice little house. Nice little car. And no plants. No plants at all.
You're talking so peculiar.
Don't worry. I'll talk to you more about it in the morning. Just go home now, Audrey, please.
No, no, no. I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything.
A pound of rare roast beef.
Maybe that'll hold you out till Life magazine gets here.
No way.
It's my last offer. Just yes or no.
It's better than nothing.
Good, done, fine. Don't think you're getting dessert.
Hey, little lady, hello. You're looking cute as can be.
Is anybody there?
You're looking mighty sweet.
Seymour?
No, it ain't Seymour, it's me. You're friendly, Audrey, too. This blend is talking. Talks.
I'm dreaming.
No, and you ain't in Kansas neither.
Something is very wrong here.
Relax and go with it, doll. Do me a favor, will you, sweetheart?
A favor?
I need me some water in the worst way. Look at my branch. I'm a goner, honey. Come on and give me a drink. Hey, little lady, be nice. I'll drink it straight.
Okay, but you
don't need no glass or no ice.
I got the can.
Don't need no crystal light. And now it's supper time. Relax and go with the dog. It'll be easier. Come on, join your game for the good things that right inside.
Audrey, you okay?
Yes. No.
Don't die, Audrey, please. I need you.
You know, Ben just said the strangest thing right now. I said for Mr. Mush to come on when you're already inside.
It's true, I did it. I fed them to it, but I didn't kill them.
That's what made it so big and strong? And you so famous?
Oh, I've done some terrible things, Audrey. But not to you. Never to you.
But I want you to see me.
What?
When I die, that should be very shortly.
Crowbar? Seymour Crowbar?
Go away!
Patrick Munden, Licensing and Marketing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. I've got a tilt-edge proposition for you, though.
I'm not interested.
Sure you are. Let me explain in more detail. It's a simple licensing deal. We take some leaves and cuttings, develop little larger tubes, and sell them to florists across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America will have one. Why? With the right advertising, you could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops?
Much bigger.
Every household in America, thousands of you eating. That's what you always had in mind, wasn't it?
No shit, Sherlock.
We're not talking about one hungry plant here. We're talking about world conquest.
And I want to thank you.
You're a monster, and so am I.
Big man.
You ate the only thing I ever loved.
Ah, too bad.
Take that!
Give up, Crowbar.
Here, rat poison. Eat it. Maybe you're tough on the outside, but in there, in that pot of yours, I'll rip you to shreds. I'll tear you apart from the inside. Come on, open up! Open up!
Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed.
change your tone. Don't you threaten me, son. You got a lot of gall. We're gonna do things my way. Some good advice. You better take it easy, 'cause you're walking on thin ice. You don't know what you're dealing with. No, you never did. You don't know what you're looking at. But that's tough titty, kid. The lion don't sleep tonight, and if you pull his tail, he roars. You see, that ain't fair. You see, that ain't nice. Know what I say of yours. I'm from Paris.